Welcome to Auto Technic. Today I wanted to run through a video talking about valve shrouding, and really the main point of this video is just kind of talking about paying attention to details when you're building an engine. So the main thing that I want to talk about, and this engine is the best example, is this is a 396 block, and it runs just barely over a 4-inch bore. And is what you'll notice on the cylinder heads, which most all big block Chevy cylinder heads are the same. You know, they have the different size combustion chambers, a large or a small combustion chamber. And this is a smaller size. I believe these are this, you know, semi-closed chamber. They measured out, I think, around 110 cc's. But if you measure the cross-section of this chamber about where the valves are, you can see that they measure, it's, you know, 4.41 inches. So almost 4.5 inches of that diameter right there. Now, remember me mentioning this block only has a 4-inch bore. So we have a combustion chamber that has a diameter that's almost 1/2 inch larger than the deck surface of this block. So that's meaning that the combustion chamber is actually overhanging the edge of the block. So when you have the air coming out from the valve, especially on the intake valve, it's so close to the edge of this chamber, it's actually coming out off the valve and it's running down the side of the edge of this chamber, so it's shrouding it. And it's gonna follow, but then it's gonna hit a ledge on the deck. So, is what I've shown here is this quick picture, and you can see that, say, this is the intake valve. You can see how this represents the deck, and we actually have the combustion chamber overhanging, so the airflow is gonna come in and hit that deck right there. So not only is that gonna create turbulence, but it's just airflow restriction. So you'll notice on some factory big blocks that they actually have notching on the side for the intake valves, where they notch onto the deck surface into the cylinder, and it's like a small little C cut that's in there. On this block, you'll be able to see where I went ahead and I've notched out the tops of the deck, so that way the deck surface follows the shape of the combustion chamber. And I've actually ran that taper down as far as I can, not getting into the top where the top piston ring sits. So I've done that on the intake and exhaust. And again, like I mentioned, if you really do some digging on this on the internet, you can find information about it, but it's really, I think it should be easier to find than that. I mean, most of us that are building these engines, this is really free horsepower, so there's no reason not to do it. And again, it's not just these engines. Now, granted, a larger bore 427 or 454 aren't as affected because your bore is naturally larger, but that small block, it does the same thing. Granted, it's not nearly as bad, but I still can do the same thing and notch this out and help de-shroud this, so that way when the air comes in, yeah, there's still gonna be some shrouding where it comes in, but it's not gonna hit that lip. It's almost like an exaggerated mushroom up top where the airflow will come in around the valve and kind of curl in and down to the chamber. So in order to do this, is what I end up doing is, you can see on this small block, I went ahead and I run dichem on the deck surface with the head off. And then I'll end up leaving the block bare like this one and putting the cylinder head on. Now, when I do this, I keep my head specific from side to side because I know there is variances on the cylinder heads. And I don't really, like, basically the head, I in my eyes, is married to that side of the block because I'm modifying the deck for that cylinder head. So once I have the dichem on and I'll bolt the head on, I'll go ahead and rotate the engine over and access it from the bottom. Now that we have access from the bottom with the rotating assembly out, you can look up and actually see the combustion chamber, and if I get this just right, you can actually easily see how it overhangs the deck surface. So as what I do is I use a hooked scribe like so, and I'll reach in to this chamber and I'm take the scribe and I run that scribe on the outside wall of the combustion chamber on the deck surface. And my intention is to mark the deck surface where that chamber sits, and that gives me the outside perimeter line of where to go ahead and grind. Now, you do that on both sides of the chamber on all 8 cylinders, and then you pull the head back off. And like I mentioned, I've already done that here on this 327 block, and it's not as much. You can see right here, and it looks not as bad as it really is because they have the chamfer on the cylinder, but it's maybe an eighth of an inch here. And you can see where I've scribed it, where this one just a little bit of cleanup, and I don't have to be nearly as aggressive. But it's quite dramatic on these blocks. So if we come over here, you can see that I've really took a lot out, and it takes a little bit of time in measuring so you get your depth right and the shape, and you just, you know, nice and easy. And I have seen other jobs where you can have a machine shop do this, and if they have a nice mill, they can do a lot better job than hand grinding it. But this really cleans it up quite a bit, and it really unshrouds the valve. And like I said, this is a great example of engine, the 327, or excuse me, the 396 is a great example for it because it has such small bores for a big block. Now, one thing to keep in mind that, you know, let's say you have a 396 you're comparing to a 427, and you think, yeah, I have an extra 30 cubic inches, so it's going to make more power. But what a lot of people don't realize is you have a lot more power because you have a larger bore, and it's naturally de-shrouding the valve more simply because of that larger bore. And if you really want to dive deep into this, you can look into some engines where, you know, the larger the bore size, if you get into the aftermarket big block Chevys where they're running a 4.5 inch bore, that unshrouds it even further to where your bore is now even bigger than your combustion chamber. So, like I said, that's a prime engine. It still applies to that small block, but in reality, this can apply to any engine. And that brings me back to what I mentioned earlier. This is all about paying attention to the details and just looking for those little things that you can change to free up some power. You know, I had to remove so much material on this block, I will lose some compression, but what I will gain in airflow and CFM and de-shrouding the valve by far outweighs it. So definitely worth it. When you guys are building engines, look for these small things and be willing to go out there and grind on it and make some changes. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching the video. I hope it was helpful for you. If you have any comments, please drop them below, and please check out my channel for more content. Thanks for watching.